Hello everyone, this is Dina Menezes, one of the staffs is working at MedCity International Academy, Mangalore. Today I am here in order to give you a few tips of finding out the main purpose of your letter when you're doing the OET writing. Many of the candidates fail to understand what is the main purpose that is hidden in the letter. Usually what happens is that when the OET people are going to give you the stimulus sometimes may focus that the medical issue of the patient could be the primary problem. But on the other hand, 50% of the letters, we have to be very careful enough because always the diagnosis or the medical problem of the patient may not be the main focus of the letter. So therefore, today I have got a case notes for you, which is Vamuya Obeki, and this case notes is one of the samples that I have selected in order to explain you guys regarding the selection of the main purpose of your letter. So if you're ready, let's go here. Yeah. So according to the writing task here, the task is saying that using the information, write a letter to the director, community child health service, and then they have given an address regarding follow up of this family. Now this is something that we read in the first 5 minutes because this particular information will guide you to three things. The first thing is the purpose of your letter, which is nothing but the follow up. The second thing that it's going to concentrate is the person or the profession of the reader to whom you're writing your letter. And the third thing, is it a known or an unknown client? So these are the three things that you have to identify from the writing task that is given to you. Now, when we are coming in detail to the case notes, we can see that they have given a date and they have given the background history of the data, saying that the Vamuya was admitted through child's emergency department with acute meningoencephalitis due to mumps. The moment you read this, many of the candidates select this as the main issue. But this is not the main issue of your letter. So therefore, many of the students are going to write, this letter is written on behalf of the above mentioned patient or maybe Mr. or Master Vamuya. He's recovering from acute meningoencephalitis caused due to the complication of mumps. Whereas that will not be the focus. Let's see. They've given the patient history and they've given the gender, the discharge and the country of birth is born in Sudan. And then we've got the social history where the parents, they're talking about the sibling language, and then they are talking about the medical history. Here we can see in the medical history that the parents state that both children had some kind of vaccination at birth, but the vaccination record has been lost and the parents are unaware of the vaccination for mumps. This is guiding you to a particular thing. And the discharge plan is also talking, appears to have fully recovered from mumps and acute meningoencephalitis. The second one is will need advice on recommended vaccines for both children. And the third one is will need neurological checkup. So when you're reading this case notes, it's very clear to understand that this is not the main issue, because here in the discharge plan, it clearly says that appears to have fully recovered. That means presently the patient doesn't have any problems with his recovery. Then the focus of your letter slowly shifts towards the advice on recommended vaccines. So it is clearly understood, and here also it is telling you that the parents are unaware of the vaccination for mumps. This clearly states that the purpose of your letter is basically focusing on health education and not on the recovery of Vamuya. Now, therefore, we have to also see that this particular person is 22/4/2015 is his date of birth. That means the patient's date of admission or the date of admission that we have, it's in the year of 2019. Now, when we are writing about 2019, the date of birth here says that he is 2015 born. That means the client is 4 years old. So, can you give health education to a 4 year old boy? It's not possible. So that's why including the client and his family or the parents is the purpose of your letter. So you can write like this letter is written or the purpose of this letter, however you want to. I'll give you just one sample. This letter is written on behalf of the above mentioned patient and his family. We have to write the family and not the parents once again. Why? Because this particular patient has got a sibling who is 2 year old brother. That means he also requires immunizations because immunization is given below the age of 5 years. So therefore, we're gonna write it like this, that this letter is written on behalf of Vamuya and his family who require health education regarding the current immunization schedule as they are unaware about the vaccination for the mumps. This would be the best introduction that you can give. So similarly, there are different samples, and this is how you have to find out what is the purpose of your letter. So this is a small clip from our site. If you want more information, please do visit MedCity International Academy anytime. Thank you for watching.